Good morning, students. In the front-end design tool, VB.NET lecture series, today we will discuss introduction to procedures. So, introduction to procedures. In this, we will discuss introduction to procedures, how calling procedures, argument passing mechanism, and scope of variable. First of all, what is a procedure? A procedure is a group of statements that together perform a task when called. After the procedure is executed, the control returns to the statement calling the procedure. VB.NET has two type of procedures. Number one, functions and sub procedures or subs. Function return a value, whereas sub procedures do not return a value. So you should remember one point, that function return a value, whereas sub procedure do not return a value. Visual Basic uses several type of procedures. Number one, sub procedures, which will perform actions but do not return a value to the calling code. Event handling procedures are sub procedures that execute in response to an event raised by user. Suppose you are clicking a button, so a procedure, and that according to that the function will be executed. Event raised by user action or by an occurrence in a program. The second procedures, function procedures, which will return a value to the calling code. They can perform other actions before returning. Some functions written in C# return a reference return value. Function callers can modify the return value, and this modification is reflected in the state of the called object. Starting with Visual Basic 2017, Visual Basic code can consume reference return values, although it cannot return a value by reference. The third type of procedure is property procedures. It will return and assign values to properties on objects or modules. Operator procedures define the behavior of a standard operator when one or both of the operands is a newly defined class or structure. So here we have discussed the type of sub procedure. One is sub procedures, function procedures, property procedures, operator procedures, and so on. Now, defining a function, the function statement is used to declare the name parameter in the body of a function. The syntax for the function statement is modifiers. Okay, function, keyword, function name, parameter list as return type, then statement, then end function. Where modifier specify the access level of function, that is public may be there in the modifier, private may be there, protected may be there, friend may be there, protected friend may be there, and information regarding overloading, overriding, sharing, and shadowing. Function name indicates the name of the function. Parameter list specifies the list of the parameters. Return type specifies the data type of the variable and function return. So these are some example. Here you can see function, function name, parameter list as return type. This is a general syntax. In the following statement, immediately transfer control back to the calling code and return the value of expression. It will return the expression, and this is the end function. So the syntax is function, function name, and last in the last is end function. Now see, function, function name, parameter list, return type. this is the following statement that does not transfer control back to the calling code here when control returns to the calling code expression in the return value. You know, you are returning the value in the form of an expression. So these are two types of, you can say, the function example. To call a function procedures in an assignment statement, use the function procedure name following the equal sign in the assignment statement. Follow the procedure name with parentheses to enclose the argument list. If there are no argument, you can optionally omit the parentheses. However, using the parentheses makes your code easier to read. Place the arguments in the argument list within the parentheses separated by commas. Be sure you supply the arguments in the same order that the function procedure defines the corresponding parameter, unless you are passing them by name. The value returned from the procedure is stored in the variable or properties on the left side of the assignment statement. To call a function procedure in an assignment statement, in this way you can see this here is the message box value of the path is ampersand environment and path. So the following example calls the Visual Basic environment to retrieve the value of an operating system environment variable. In the first line, calls environment within an expression. In the second line, calls it in an assignment statement. Okay, environment takes the variable name as its sole argument and it returns the variable's value to the calling code. To call a sub procedure, specify the name of the sub procedure. Follow the procedure name with parentheses to enclose the argument list. If there are no arguments, you can optionally omit the parentheses. However, using the parentheses makes your code easier. Place the argument in the argument list within the parentheses separated by commas. Be sure you supply the argument in the same order that the sub procedure defines the corresponding parameter. Here you can see in the following example calls the Visual Basic application activate function. Here you can see the application activate function. To activate an application window, application activate takes the window title as its sole argument. It does not return a value to the calling code. If a notepad process is not running, the example throws an argument exception. The shell procedure assumes the application are in the path specified. Let's see. Here you are defining dim notepad ID as integer. It's a integer, you can say, variable. Now, activate a running notepad process. App activate untitled notepad. Now, app activate can also use the return value of the shell function. Shell runs a new instance of notepad. Notepad ID equals to shell. This is the, notepad.exe. Apply window style or normal focus. Now activate this. App activate, we are passing this argument, notepad ID. So in this way it is, running. Argument passing mechanism. We are passing argument in a VB.NET with the two ways. One is called by value and one is by reference. In Visual Basic, you can pass an argument to a procedure by value or by reference. This is known as the passing mechanism and is determined whether the procedure can modify the programming element underlying the argument in the calling code. The procedure declaration determines the passing mechanism for each parameter by specifying the by val or by reference keyword. These are two keywords. One is by value and another is the by reference. Argument passing mechanism. When passing an argument to a procedure, be aware of several different distinctions that interact with each other. One, whether the underlying programming element is modifiable or non-modifiable. Whether the argument itself is modifiable or non-modifiable. whether the argument is being passed by value or passed by reference, whether the argument data type is a value type or a reference type. Number C, when we are passing, when to pass an argument by value. When we are passing an argument by value or when we are passing an argument by reference. So first of all, we will see when to pass an argument by value. If the calling code element underlying the argument is a non-modifiable element, declare the corresponding parameter by value. No code can change the value of a non-modifiable element. So if the underlying element is modifiable, but you do not want to procedure to be able to change its value, declare the parameter by value. Only the calling code can change the value of a modifiable element passed by value. When to pass an argument by reference, if the procedure has a genuine need to change the underlying element in the calling code, declare the corresponding parameter by reference. If the correct execution of the code depends on the procedure changing the underlying element in the calling code, declare the parameter by reference. If you pass it by value, or if the calling code overrides the by reference passing mechanism by enclosing the argument in parentheses, the procedure call might produce unexpected result. So here one example, here is the module 1, submain. So two interest rates are declared, one are constant high rate as double. It is declared one is constant and another is a variable. Dim low rate equals to high rate multiplied by 0.6. Another one is initial depth equals to 4999.99. Make a copy of the original value of the depth. Dim depth with interest equals to initial depth. Now we will calculate the total depth with the high interest rate applied. Argument high rate is a constant, which is appropriate for a by value parameter. So argument depth with interest must be a variable, because the product is when we are multiplying it, so total with interest applied. Again, calculate is a function in which we are passing two arguments, high rate and depth with interest. Format the result to represent currency and display it. Dim depth string equals to format depth with interest, the console dot write line, what I owe with high interest and percent depth string. Repeat the process with low rate. Argument low rate is not a constant but the by value parameter. Protects it from accidental or intentional change by the procedure. So set depth with interest back to the original value. Depth with interest equals to initial depth. In this way, this by value will be demonstrated. The parameter rate is a by value parameter because the procedure should not change the value of the corresponding argument in the calling code. And the calculated value of the depth parameter, however, should be reflected in the value of the corresponding argument in the calling code. Therefore, it must be declared by reference. So here sub procedure calculate by value rate as double and by reference depth. Rate we have taken by value and depth we have taken as by reference. Okay. So in this way, these two things we have been discussed. Now there is another term that is called scope of variable. We have seen variable is scope of a variable. The scope of variable is where it is, its value is kept and can be referred in the code. The scopes in VB.NET are classified into four types. One is called block scope, procedure scope, module scope, and namespace scope. First of all, a local variable is a variable declared inside a sub or function that is called a local variable. A local variable scope is its enclosing block. So until then, the parenthesis will be there, or the sub is there, or the function is there. So it can be used from the dim statement to the last statement of the enclosing block. That is a local variable, or you can say block. If the enclosing block is a server function, it has procedure scope. If the enclosing block is a sub or function, it has procedure scope. Otherwise, it is a block scope. Mean to say, agar if you are declaring a dim A and it is declaring within some braces, so it's a block. Block scope. And if you are enclosing block in a function or procedure, then it's a procedure scope. Make the scope of variables as narrow as possible. If the scope is too wide, there is more chance of report access a wrong variable. So these errors may not be detected during compilation and are generally very difficult to fix. So the following example is a program that cannot be compiled because variable A is used before it is defined. Here we are using console.writeline A, and in the another line we are defining dim A as integer. So we are using the variable before initializing. So compile error A is declared after the statement. So it is declaring after its scope. And here is a program that cannot be compiled because the variable value is used outside of its scope. Let's see. Do dim value as integer, console.readline loop while value not equal to 1. So here we are using the value. Compile error because value is not accessible here. So the program can be corrected into one of the following way, or is in this way. Dim value as integer, do we can say value for equals to console.readline. So here we are reading the value of this value from console.readline with the help of the keyword, and do loop while value not equal to 1. So in this way it is corrected. A variable has a module scope if its enclosing block is a module or class. So module scope variable can be referenced throughout that particular module, not just by the code after the declaration. Therefore, the following code is valid: module, module 1, submain, console.writeline A, print 3, and sub dim A as integer equals to 3. Here you can see we are defining the A integer variable A after we are using, but since it is a module variable, so it will work fine. Namespace scope variable. So namespace scope available to all the code in the namespace in which it is declared. However, if you declare an element at module level using the friend or public keyword, it becomes available to all procedures throughout the namespace in which the element is declared. With the following alteration to the preceding examples, the string variable, string message can be referred to by code anywhere in the namespace of its declaration. So simply you can say that if we are putting a before variable name or it's a module label and we are putting a public, so public string message is a string, then it can be used as a namespace scope. If your project does not contain any namespace statement, everything in the project is in the same namespace. In this case, namespace scope can be thought of as project scope. Public elements in a module, class, or structure are also available to any project that reference their project. So these are, the scopes of the variables. One is the block label, procedure label, module label, and namespace. These are some of the references. So here I will stop. Thank you for your listening. And in the next class, we will discuss control flow statements. Okay. So thank you. Thank you very much.